Welcome to Keep It Civil with me, Winston Pagliaro. Recent feature additions to ReCap have opened doors for us when it comes to generating surfaces from point cloud data. Today, we're going to compare the previous workflow of creating a ground surface to what I believe to be a faster, more powerful alternative that will soon become the standard. Let's dive in. First, a quick overview on what these recent feature additions are. ReCap 2023.1 saw the introduction of point classification management and automatic ground classification. By classification management, ReCap could now not only interpret classification data, but perform basic display-related functions like hiding classifications, changing their color, and deleting them. For automatic ground classification, ReCap could take a cloud that had no classifications and attempt to sift out which points were ground points. For a closer look at that feature, I'll leave a link in the description. ReCap 2024.1, which was released last month, introduced manual classification, which made it so you could manually select and reclassify points. This was greatly needed since automatic ground classification usually did a decent job, but generally required some cleanup. Pair it with Intelligent Decimation, which offers targeted point reduction options, and you now have the tools to redefine the surface creation workflow. Before we jump into the surface creation workflow comparison, I want to quickly show you how easy manual classification is. In this project, this point cloud has data in two classifications: ground points in brown, and everything else is unclassified in gray. Let's say I want to place some streetlights on their own classification. I'm going to turn off the ground points to make the lights easier to select. Then it's as simple as selecting the points and assigning a new classification. In this case, I'll choose a reserved classification. I'll quickly do one more and then rename that classification by double-clicking on it. I'll also give it a different color. Now onto the workflow comparison. What I'm going to do here is have both workflows side by side with a timer running to compare the time it takes to complete them. On the left is the new workflow utilizing ReCap's new classification and decimation features. On the right is the old workflow, whereby the entire point cloud is inserted into Civil 3D, and then Map 3D functions are used to filter out just the ground data. Both will use the same point cloud and a target reduction size of 50%. Since it's a little difficult to see in detail with the split screen, I'll zoom in on some key points for the new workflow. If you want to see the old workflow in more detail, I'll leave a link in the description. In ReCap, I've turned off all classifications except what I want to export. This is very important because whatever is visible will export. I'll browse to home, click the new button for Intelligent Decimation, and this dialog pops up. Firstly, which classification do I want to decimate? I want my ground data. Secondly, where do I want those points to wind up? This is a key point. They aren't automatically deleted, but reclassified. You can choose to delete them later if you want, but for now, I'm going to place them onto a reserved classification. And next, we actually specify point reduction either by percentage or by number. I'll choose 50%. The number of points could be very useful if you have a specific target in mind, like if you're trying to skirt under the MMS threshold later on in Civil 3D. Once decimation is done, I'll export to a unified RCS file. Hey y'all, it's Winston here. So full disclosure, I actually forgot to turn off the classification for my decimated points in this video. I caught it later and went back. Just goes to show how easy it is to forget. Remember that everything that is visible exports, and decimated points aren't turned off automatically. They're reclassified. From here on in Civil, there's nothing new. I attach my unified RCS containing just ground points, check that it's roughly in the correct place, and then create a surface from it. I'll let those two workflows finish up in the background, but for the sake of time, I'll go ahead and bring up the results for my point cloud of about 18 million points, a little over 12 million of which were ground data. The new workflow came in at about 3 minutes, 30 seconds. The old Map3D workflow came in at just over 10 minutes. Most of that was waiting for the surface to be created, and then more waiting when simplifying it. It's clear that the first workflow, which utilizes ReCap's latest classification and intelligent decimation features, is far faster. And I didn't even include the fact that the resulting surface from the old Map3D workflow needed some boundary cleanup, which would have taken additional time. ReCap handles large amounts of point cloud data far better than Civil 3D, so whatever processing can be done before Civil 3D, the better. Obviously, results will vary based on what's in your point cloud, but so far, I'm very impressed with ReCap's latest classification features. I encourage you to install the 2024.1 update and try it out yourself. Thanks for watching.